everyone. Welcome to the RFID kit for Arduino tutorial series. Today we will learn lesson 5, I2C LCD1602. In this experiment, we will use a commonly used display, LCD1602. We can see it everywhere in our daily life. But this time, the LCD1602 we use is one with an I2C bus port, which has only 2 bidirectional data lines because it occupies less I/O ports of the controller. Okay, now please follow me to do the experiment. Let's get started. First, let's look at the experimental phenomenon. We can see on the LCD, the word SunFounder is displayed at the top and flows from right to left. And after a while, the sentence "Hello World" is displayed at the bottom and flows from right to left. Now let's take a look at the components we need for the experiment. A USB cable, several jumper wires, SunFounder Uno board, and the I2C LCD1602. Let's first get to know some information about the LCD1602. As we all know, though LCD and some other displays greatly enrich the man-machine interaction, they share a common weakness. When they are connected to a controller, multiple I/Os will be occupied of the controller, which has not so many outer ports. Also, it restricts other functions of the controller. Therefore, LCD1602 with an IOC port is developed to solve the problem. It is also simple to handle. It has only 2 bidirectional data lines, a serial data line and a serial clock line. Knowing the device, let's build the circuit. Connect pin SDA of the LCD1602 to pin A4 of the SunFounder Uno board. SCL to A5. VCC to 5 volts of the board, and then connect the ground of the 2. Okay, now the circuit is completed. Next, open the integrated development environment, namely IDE. Type in your code. This is a header file. It includes the wire library and liquid crystal I2C function library, which include all functions to be used later. Now initialize array 1, which is a character type, as SunFounder. It has 26 characters in total. Then initialize the array 2 as Hello World. It also has 26 characters. Define an integer 10 as 250. It includes the delay time. Set the initial address of LCD as 27H for a 16 column and 2 row display. The setup function is to initialize a variable. Define the input or output status of a pin and begin to apply a library at the start of the program. Initialize the LCD. Turn on the backlight. The loop function does precisely what its name suggests and loops consecutively, allowing your program to change and respond. The LCD set cursor function is to set the position of the cursor. Here we set it as column 15, row 0. Since the length of the array is 26 characters, the position counter 1 counts from 0 to 25. When it counts 0, run the following code. After 26 cycles, the loop exits. What the LCD print function does is to print text to the LCD. Here we set the contents to be displayed on the LCD. This part is to cause the string SunFounder to flow from right to left. Scroll the contents of the display one bit to the left. Then we make a delay of 250 milliseconds. Clear strings on the LCD screen and position the cursor at the upper left corner. This part is to display the string "Hello World" and cause it to flow from right to left. Scroll the contents of the display one bit to the left. Print the string to the LCD. Reset the LCD. To learn more about the functions mentioned above, you can visit the official website of Arduino and search for the Liquid Crystal Library. It contains all the functions for LCD. Compile the code and, oops, an error just pops up. Check the code and we can see the header file. Include wire edge is missing. Type in the code. Compile it again. Then connect the SunFounder Uno board to a computer and download the program. So now we can see the word SunFounder displayed on the LCD and flowing from right to left. And after a while, the sentence "Hello World" flows from right to left at the bottom. That's all for our experiment. Just now we found an error, and we can't be too careful during experiments. Now, have you finished your experiment yet? You can also try to modify the program to display other strings. As usual, if you have any questions or you want to share your ideas and creation, do not hesitate to post on our website, www.sunfounder.com. Or you can email us at support@sunfounder.com. See you next lesson. Bye.